Hey minions, welcome to Crank It Up. I'm Jim Price, and today I want to talk about goblins. The goblins are a new micro-expansion faction coming in 2021, and I'll get ahead of this question and say that I don't have a specific date. The goblins focus on flipping coins and triggering events based on the results. In lieu of an extended introduction, I'm just going to jump right into the video and begin with a few important caveats. First, this is a difficult video to make because trying to label the goblins is difficult. Are they a headliner? Are they support? When do you draft them? These are questions not easily answered. Additionally, the goblins are, in some aspects, the opposite of my playstyle, and they appear to rely on luck, randomness, and chaos, but that's not entirely true, and not for the reasons you would guess. I would say that there are things that I like and things that I don't, but I want to stress from the beginning that the goblins are a faction you need to play before arriving at a conclusion for two reasons. First, there's a very personal experience awaiting you with the coin flips, as some people claim to have terrible luck or terrific luck. Second, there is more that is going on behind the scenes, and you don't fully appreciate it until you play them. My final caveat is that I can talk a lot about probability and odds, but I'm not going to, because that's actually the wrong way of thinking about goblins. One final reminder, since I believe not every card should be spoiled, leaving something as a surprise, I won't go into the usual level of detail or coverage, but by the end of this video, you should get a good sense of the goblin playstyle, which I'll break down into three parts: the flip, the blip, and the tip. The gobbo is an example of a flip. You flip a coin for each gobbo in play, getting counters on heads. You have a 50-50 shot of getting a counter, and they have four gobbos, so you could be flipping four times. But you have to remember about the blip, which takes two forms. The diviners can, once per turn, change the result of a coin flip to a more favorable result. Additionally, they draw a card once per turn after your first flip. This is the blip players can see coming. The other form is make your own luck, a special played from hand that just inverts the flip. Both of these happen before reactions to the flip, like a momentary interruption. And if these are the only two aspects to the goblins, I would call them a gimmick, as the coin flip seems superfluous and time-consuming, with no real cost since you can just change the flip. But this is the wrong way to think about goblins. While there are still aspects of a gimmick, I haven't decided on its full gimmick status yet because of the tip, the hidden potential of the faction, and it's summarized in both Goblin Recruiters and their King Minion, but I'll be talking about Goblin Recruiters today. These are easily the two most important cards in the Goblin deck, with Goblin Recruiters sometimes feeling like a necessity. Why? Because goblins aren't necessarily about the flip results, in my opinion. They are about the flips themselves. Goblin Recruiters is a rare example of an action whose location means nothing. It's like a permanent effect, similar to Woodland Helpers. After every coin flip, you get a positive benefit, but it may not be the one you want. On heads, you draw a card. On tails, you can recur a card. And I will say that this gives the goblins potentially insane card draw, because an ability like Gobbo is more about the flips it generates than the actual power counters it receives. Think about the two cards together. Your power 2 is either drawing a card or shuffling a card into your deck, both powerful abilities from that card slot, and it can potentially trigger 4 times. The same phenomenon occurs when you play a card like He Who Smelt It. If you go crazy on heads, the power is nice, but the real treat is the repeated flipping. Let's say you had just 1 heads and 1 tails. You end up with a card draw, a power counter, an extra action, and a card shuffled into your deck. That's basically an on guard that adds a permanent power and recurs another card, but with a potential for more. Think of a card like Demolition. If you are relying on either outcome, you probably won't get it unless you make your own luck, but you get a guaranteed 3 flips, which means that you can recur 3 cards, or draw 3 cards, or any combination in between when you are only subject to the order of the flip. And this is in addition to the actual outcome of the flip. 3 counters and 3 cards would be very strong. You could absolutely play this faction going for luck, but I wouldn't. With a card like Revving Up, you know you will get at least 1 power per minion. If you were reaching for the 2 temporary power, it would be expensive to change all those flips, and failing to achieve your goal would be a ton of power creep, and a waste of opportunity. But using this action as a form Mergercon-style play that produces flips is where the real value is. For each goblin action, when determining its value, you need to consider both the result of the flip and the quantity of the flips, since both have value. And in the case of their 2 key engine cards, I believe the flip itself is more valuable than its result. Instead, I choose to save my goblin blip cards for when the outcome truly matters. Singular flips that require more determinism. A little help is one of those double features. Unless you are content with either outcome, you really need to be able to influence it in the direction of your choice. A better example would be bushwhacking, which has you choose the minion before you flip. This, to me, almost necessitates needing a blip card, because why would you choose your own minion, intending to move it, and risk destroying it? Or if you really needed a minion destroyed, why risk not destroying it? But my personal preference is moving the rival minion to score a base because it has the same effect as destruction but serves my immediate purpose, and I wouldn't want to risk losing that. As you can see, the goblin cards are a strange mix of terminal and situational. It's not always easy figuring out the right time to play them, but there are definitely wrong times, and deciding between the two is at the heart of their complexity. So now that you get a better sense of the goblin cards, it's time to revisit that first question. What are they? I think that their mass card draw makes them a support faction, especially when combined with their recursion. They offer a bit of utility that comes with a catch, but they allow you to really lean into your primary faction by drawing and recurring their cards at large. Many players will look at this faction, see the coin flips, and try to figure out how to synergize with that, but that's the wrong direction. It's better to ask what the goblins can do for you, because unless you can find a way to maximize the flips, the synergy will be one direction only. That being said, one of the great partners is a faction I really get to talk about, the All-Stars. If you assume a little bit of luck, or if you have access to your four blip cards, He Who Smelt It can become insufferable quickly. Non-infinite loop can play He Who Smelt It, which grants an extra action. This can lead into It's Astounding to play non-infinite loop to play He Who Smelt It again, which again grants an extra action, and it's back into your hand. If Ghostly Arrival preceded any of this and was banked, letting it go to the discard pile, Ghostly Arrival could be shuffled into your deck on the first tails and potentially drawn again. And mass draw with mass recursion can lead to playing the same cards over and over again, and for the All-Stars, that ceiling is quite high. The All-Stars also have multiple ways of recurring this key action. When you combine the card hunting abilities of the faction with their action recurrence, Goblin Recruiters becomes a repeated inevitability, especially if it shuffles in the other recursion cards. Throw in the fact that the Gelf can grab a Diviner, and a Sprout can grab the powerful Goblin 3, and it only further rounds out the synergy. So that's my brief preview on the Goblins. Hopefully this gives you more of a feel for what they are trying to do, while still leaving some surprises in store. What do you think of this new faction? Let me know in the comments. Thanks for joining us on Christmas Day, and I hope that you have a great holiday season with your family. Thanks for watching, be sure to like and subscribe, let's shut it down.